assembly is now over. Teachers will escort you out of the building. Walk, do not run. Students, look for your teachers outside the auditorium. They'll give you further instructions. Now clear the auditorium. Now.
All of you, come over here. I don't care. Just get in here right now. All of you, inside. I don't have time for that. Just go inside and wait.
Wait for what? Come on. Lock the door.
No, we can't do that. This is an infringement of our civil rights.
I can't believe this is happening to me.
Believe it.
There must be a good reason. We should just calm down and be patient.
Oh, please, man. They don't need to have a reason. I get this all the time.
What are you doing? We're going to get in so much trouble.
I'm shaking.
Please, put it out.
Well, what, are you scared too?
No, we don't have to breathe that crap.
Don't breathe. I'll open the window.
Do you see anything?
Nothing.
Barry, get off my chair.
Thanks. At least there's one gentleman in this world.
I'm the only one here that really cares about protecting the law.
Dear, such a dick, Devin!
want to know you, Muhalem?
Hey, I know who you are, all right. And my name's David G. I'm famous.
Yeah, you're a legend in your own mind.
Oh no, the stuck-up bitch doesn't like me.
Maybe that's why. Because you're extremely obnoxious.
Darn. That's a pretty name. Why don't you come sit on my lap, baby, so we can get to know each other better.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Oh, everybody's so antisocial. What is it, problems at home? Or too many single-parent families? What's up with you, Hoochie? What are you so upset about?
I want to go home.
What's so good about home? What, your mommy laying out the cookies and milk for you right about now?
I'm upset about what happened. If you had feelings, you might be too.
So you want to go home and cry with your mom?
No.
Little perfect girl in a little perfect home. Tell me something. You got a lot of dollies to go in your little teen bedroom?
Well, it's obvious you don't get too many girlfriends now, do you? But what's so bad about wanting to be at home?
I wouldn't know. I don't spend that much time there.
Is that why you're so screwed up? You got a crummy home life, so it makes it all right for you to take it out of the office. Is that it?
Watch too much Ricky Lake, man. I don't go home because it's a drag. I got better things to do.
Oh, yeah, like what?
Like sitting here watching y'all squirm to pass the time.
God.
I know what you mean about going home. I read this article. A home is more than a place.
Smack, shut the hell up. You bored the hell out of all of us.
The survey said the whole idea of the American family is breaking down. Single parent families, families with two working parents. Kids are growing up at daycare. There's no normal American family.
What's so bad about that? Parents don't have a lot of options, you know.
Yeah, but we're the products of our environment.
Oh, come on. I think that's just an excuse. You can't blame everything on your family. You could be whatever you want to be if you put your mind to it. Or you can sit around and waste your time and complain that you never had a chance. But it's up to the individual.
Yeah, but there's some things that are hard to rise above. Yeah. If it's rough at home, that can seriously screw you up.
But it's possible to rise above it. Some people do. And some people don't.
Yeah, well, it's a harsh world out there. And where I come from, everything's dangerous. You can't even go to school without being checked for guns at the door or drugs in the classroom. And teachers, they're more worried about staying alive than teaching anyone.
So, what's your point?
My point is you're supposed to feel safe at home. And if that's not working for you, then you've got to look somewhere else.
Yeah, right. I mean, that's what a lot of my friends are doing.
I don't think so. I think you're all just using that as an excuse. We make decisions every day. I don't accept that we're not responsible for any of
them. We're responsible, but we're products of our environment.
So, Dr. Smack, if I move in with you and your family, could I be as good a kid as you and Mrs. Socha over there?
Maybe.
Could I make straight A's, plant assemblies, and go to college? Would I be a better person?
Yes.
Saying Buddy was better than anybody else. I was just telling you about the study.
Study my ass, dude. This is a
hey, leave him alone.
Put it out.
What, you don't think it matters if some kids or parents that ever home or whacked out on drugs and alcohol? Or some that get off on smacking them around? Of course, you and the stuck-up bitch who rise above that, below life's like
he
me.
He wasn't trying.
It's okay, it's not me he's mad at. There's something else bothering me.
Nothing else is bothering me, you got that? Except for maybe you, Dr. Smack.
He's agreeing.
Don't agree with me! Don't even talk to me, man. I don't want to hear any more of your shit. Don't piss me off. Next time you do, I'll hurt you.
Why are you such a jerk?
It's not my fault, right? I'm a product of my environment.
Rhea!
Alan!
Shut up!
Just more cop cars, alright?
That's cop cars.
Damn, it's like 10. Just something serious just went down.
Did anybody see anything?
No.
There must have been something going down in front of the auditorium.
It was those gangbangers.
You saw it.
No, but it had to be them.
You know, you don't know that.
Sure, I do. That's the only way they know how to deal with anything is through violence. I think we should just let them kill each other.
Uh-huh, this is coming from someone who at Latin Assembly held the Oswald's Peace Party.
It was a great idea.
You're right.
But I should have known someone would screw it up. They're such a bunch of losers.
What? Look, pointing fingers isn't going to get us anywhere,
yeah.
All right?
Why aren't we trying to do something constructive? I mean, we're stuck in here, you guys. We might as well make good use of our time. Well,
don't you ever give up, you little faggot. Yo, man, what is that? Man, do you even know what that word means? Or the pain that word has caused? Man, why don't you just lighten up and quit being such a bigot?
Yeah, where do you get off calling people names? Language people you don't even know.
Man, this ain't the first time.
What are you talking about?
You remember that time downtown? And yo, man, you're betting on me and my friends, calling us little beaners.
Baby, so what?
So stupid!
Guys!
Look, man, I'm full of people, I'm not Latino.
Yeah, well, maybe you should wear a sign if it bugs you so much,
hey,
man.
Guys.
Look like you're Latino.
Not
well, what's wrong with being Latino? Ain't got palm people that are different?
Not you. Look, I ain't a bigot, alright?
Bigot. Racist, redneck, fanatic, intolerant, extremist.
Why?
Now look, I'm not racist, alright? There's just some people out of life.
There's a difference.
Racism is when you hate for no reason, right? Right?
Yes.
That ain't me.
So what's your reason?
Alright, Nora. Tell me something. You ever have a knife stuck in your stomach because you're white? You know what? I'm sorry, but that makes you a little bit prejudiced too, all right?
Sorry.
Me and my friends, we ain't gonna let that happen again. We take care of each other, whatever that takes. If that means violence, that's just the way it goes.
That's how gangs get started.
Not any gang. Just look out for each other, man. Man, I'm listening to everything you're saying. Man, but you cannot stop violence with violence. People have been making that mistake for thousands of years.
Yeah, thanks, Muhammad. I'll remember those words next time I get my ass kicked.
Did you ever consider that you might bring some violence on yourself? I mean, I don't have any real problems. Maybe you and your friends are looking for trouble.
What, so you never got jumped?
No.
No one ever bombed on you just for fun? Just because you're such a little geek?
No. But I consider myself a pacifist. Maybe that's why.
You know what, man? That's really great. I'm a pacifist too. And if you step, I'm gonna pass this fist right through your face. Back up.
Now it's an ambulance.
Oh, damn.
Four pigs.
It's an ambulance, two of them.
What's going on?
I mean, one's leaving and they're loading something to the other one.
Yeah.
It looks as if someone might be on the
hold on, wait a second.
Gangsters? What about your gang?
My gang.
Yeah, everybody's in a gang. For her, it's a clique, a group of stuck-up bitches that thinks they're better than everybody else. I mean, what about the drama club? Or the debate team, the football team, or that fool's tagger group?
What about them?
Call them what you want to, they're just gangs.
The difference is those gangs don't do anything to hurt anybody.
You know what? Neither do I if people leave me alone. Why are you putting that near me?
Because you need it, Tim.
You know what? It's your house. You've got some serious attitude problem.
You better step, because I've got a problem with you, kid.
Yeah, well, I've got a problem with you. I don't like the way you've been treating people.
Well, stick your neck out for him, man. It might get cut off.
Man, why do you gotta act like such a hard guy? What, the world too tough to
you
or something?
See, look, I'm the hardest person in this room, and I don't need to take shit from anybody. Anybody. That's the way it works, world. And you need to learn how to shut up.
That's not the way it's supposed to be, man. We have to have some compassion. And if we don't learn to get along and work things out together, this world is going to be an impossible place for anybody.
Man, don't even be preacher non-violent bullshit to me, all right? That shit don't cut it with me, and it definitely don't stop me from kicking your ass. You got something else to say? Better say it.
Man, you ain't even worth my time.
That's what I thought, listen.
I have something to say.
Yo, don't push it, Smack. I ain't in the mood, all right?
I know you can mangle me and everything, but I still think we should use this time to start talking.
You look gangster here and we're talking to. It's a lost cause.
Well, it's better than yelling and screaming at each other.
What's the point? We're all too different. We'll never agree on anything.
I bet we have more in common than you think.
We're never going to talk to each other once we get out of this room.
Oh, come on, you guys. You know, maybe the kid's right. We're never gonna talk to each other, see each other again, we can say anything. Go ahead, show us.
Go ahead, show us. I'm the one with the big mouth. Okay.
What if everybody wrote down one idea? One thing that they thought would make the world better? It doesn't have to make sense, just something you believe in.
All right.
That's a good idea.
Shut up!
Good idea. Communication.
Please stop.
You ever stop?
What, did you find it hard to concentrate? I'm sorry.
Yes. You should be. Solves problems. Communication solves problems.
Most of them.
Right?
That's really deep, man. Where'd you get the fortune?
Why the hell did you do that? He's trying to help.
I don't want to play a stupid-ass game, all right?
So we all have to do what you want to do? You are so selfish. Maybe you could learn something from what happened today.
It's a pretty average day for me.
Yeah, well, you're probably used to wasting time, but I know I have better things I could be doing.
Yeah, and my assembly was ruined.
Ooh.
Of course, you wouldn't know anything about that, would you? You never try to do anything with your poor, pathetic loser life.
Yeah, and I'm going to be late for my job. And you know, some of us, we got business to take care of. Or suck if some burnout popped off that teacher or something. Shut up!
And what about you, Lucy? What do you want to complain about?
Well, I was forced to spend the day with the world's biggest male chauvinist pig.
Damn, you're fine when you get agitated. Maybe this day isn't going to be a total waste after all.
Sorry, I make it a point never to go out with someone whose IQ is lower than my dog's.
You bring the
What are we gonna get the hell out of here? Come on, we didn't do anything.
I think we're all being just a little bit selfish. What if someone really got hurt?
She's right. There were two ambulances.
And there are always ambulances. They call them someone who knows me.
Why were there so many policemen?
There were a lot of homeboys here. I'm sure somebody started acting up trying to prove how tough they were.
I think someone got hurt. Why else are they keeping us here? Why else hasn't someone come back to tell us what's going on? What if it's someone we know?
It's no one I know.
It's not my problem.
It's everybody's problem.
You want my crime for anyone? You want to run with the big dogs, you're gonna get bit, and that's all she wrote.
You really don't care if someone got hurt?
No. Yeah, look, he's right.
He's not.
It comes with the territory. You want to run with the creek and get hurt. Everyone knows that.
But how did you guys get like this?
Well, I thought you told us, Smack. Environment.
But no one's really that bad, are they? I mean, I always believed that bottom line, everybody wants the same thing. But I feel like I don't know any of you at all.
You don't, dude. That's it, you don't know me. And you're not gonna find some magic switch that turns me into your buddy, man.
Static.
I don't like you, and I don't want to like you.
And where the hell did you get that? The Neanderthal's guide to alienating people and making enemies? You know, if you lived in society instead of underneath your own cowardly rocks and place, you might just understand that we as people share the same planet. And you know, we should probably find some common ground so that we can solve some problems.
And what is this? How to be politically correct in 5 minutes by North, the hippie bitch? You know what? Some species just don't get along. You sure that's the case? I'm gonna help.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. But humans are slightly higher life forms than the rest. Although in your case, I see the similarities.
Yeah.
See? You spell out this acceptance, understanding, right? Did you think I'm a loser because of my clothes and my haircut?
You are wrong.
Am I?
I think you're a loser because of the way you treat people, period. You know, it's idiots like you. They're ruining everybody else.
You don't know where I come from or what I've been through, all right?
Oh, give me a break.
I'll break.
Having problems does not give you the right to be one. Get over it. Or do you think you are the only one that has a problem? That nobody else in this room has been through some bad shit. You know, we have.
This isn't exactly what I had in mind when I said we should talk about things. I mean, I'm sure Bill has his reasons for being a jerk.
That's it! Well, you gotta live respect, and you're gonna teach me if I have to.
Alright, guys,
take it from Chianti. I've been hoping for this moment all day.
Yeah, well, you should be careful what you hope for.
I thought you'd invite
him. Well, he's pushing me.
Don't let him do it. He's
I mean, you gotta leave him out.
No, this is ridiculous.
I'm gonna take your baby away from him.
This will all be over soon.
Guys, this shit has got to stop.
If someone should take care of those guys. Man, it's not right killing an innocent
man. It's not right killing anybody. Violence for any reason. It doesn't solve any problems. When are you people gonna finally figure that shit out?
Yeah, what do you want us to do, man?
Stop fighting back?
Then that is exactly what I want you to do. I want everybody to just stop fighting back. You know what? I want to live in a world where violence is not an option.
Those people out there, they mean business. They don't give options. That's why someone died today.
No, man, you're the reason why somebody killed today. Man, you have so much hatred, and even if you don't get killed, your life is ruined. The violence owns you, man. You want to own all of
us. It's not like I wanted this to happen, all right? Trying to tell you we have rules, man. We don't mess with anyone, they don't mess with us first.
You just don't, okay?
Oh. What am I supposed to do, huh? You tell me that. What am I supposed to
do? Yeah, but what are you supposed to do when we get stuck in the middle? We don't want to be in your war.
I don't feel safe anywhere. Now I can't even go to school without being afraid. I don't want to be scared anymore. I just want to be a kid. Is that too much to ask?
It's not fair. We're going to have gray hair before 16.
I'm not going back to school.
I'm asking my parents to move.
Where are you going to go?
We're safe.
Oh, yeah, and what's that?
I don't know, but I've got to get out of here. It's happening everywhere. Seems like everyone has seen and known someone's gotten shot.
And you know, man, I think they get off on it. And damn, life doesn't matter much to anyone anymore. There's so much violence. Take a look around. In the papers.
Yeah.
And the news and the movies and TV. And damn, people think it's actually funny when they see someone get popped. And you know, I read about the time we're in the sixth grade. We've already seen like over 100,000 acts of violence on TV. You know, a friend lives down LA. No, it's like, let's sleep in a damn bathtub. No, just so we can stay sitting on straight bullets and driveways.
We're not moving there.
We can't just run away.
We've got to get around and find a way to make things better somehow.
Yeah. All this talk, man. What does it mean? Okay, you guys, you stand here and you say, oh, make it better. And help each other, right? But that's hard to do when you're fighting for your life.
So what the hell is your answer, Stephanie? Please,
I take care of myself.
Yeah, well, who took care of my friend? He didn't hurt anybody. One minute he was standing there, and then the next minute somebody took his neck away.
Why did you want that to happen?
Sorry, that wasn't my fault. That wasn't my fault.
It is! It was! You made this world violent.
You don't know what it's like, all right? None of you! You don't live in my world! And you don't even speak my language.
Man, everybody dies in the same language.
You lay off me. Because I didn't have shit to do with it.
Bullshit! People are dumb, and that is not acceptable. Now, either you're a part of the problem or a part of the cure. Somebody hits you and you hit them back? Man, that is just way too easy. The hard part is just walking away.
I'm so preachy right now.
Yeah? Sounds real stupid to live in a world without fear, where people can get along without tearing each other apart. That's preaching for you,
Lieutenant. Yo, I'm telling you, man, waste of time. He doesn't care about anyone but himself.
Then just forget about him. Let's talk about where we go from here.
I have to learn how to take care of each other.
Well, how are we gonna do that? And look, you know, we've been ragging on each other and fighting for the last 25 minutes. There's only 7 of us. Yo, I'm telling you, man, this world's real bad shape.
We don't have to worry about the world. Just ourselves.
What do you mean?
One person. That's where it starts. One person can make a difference. We have to be brave. Look, we can't wait for somebody else to make things better for us. Now we have to put an end to this insanity.
You were the one who was just gonna fight a few minutes ago. Aren't you being a little hypocritical?
Yeah, we have to fight for what we need.
Yeah, we have to fight, but we won't have to fight.
Now, but what are you supposed to do when someone has you backed into a corner?
You have the right to protect yourself and people you care about. We all do.
Yeah, we do not have the right to bust heads because we don't like the way someone dresses or talks or their religion or who the hell they go to bed with.
You make it sound so simple, right? You make it sound so easy. But in the real world, it's not even like that.
Man, this is the real world.
No, dude. In my world, you're good as the crew you run with, that's it. We take care of each other, whatever that takes. I have to. You're the only family I got.
You know, you're not different than
really?
You. A lot of us have family problems at home.
Yes, I don't get along with my parents either.
You guys don't understand, dude. I don't mean shit to my parents, right? I died on the front steps, and my dad was up over me for a week before before he noticed. And I had a friend too once. A good friend, best friend. Nobody got smoked last year. He wasn't messing with anybody. He was minding his own business. See, I've seen this shit before, man. I don't put my trust in anybody. Cause it just disappeared. So go ahead. You talk about the world! You getting along, me turning my back! I don't know this world. If you got that, you can blame me for everything that goes down, but as far as I'm concerned, the world was a shitty place before I was born, and a shitty place now!
Excuse for what's been going on. Then we have to make this matter. And we have to change. We have to change.
How?
No.
Well, at my old school, I used to have some trouble because some kids thought I was a nerd.
How did you die?
So I told some teachers.
You read on?
No, I set a meeting. So we talk. Not as the tough guys and the nerds, but as people with problems. We got really honest with each other and talked about stuff that bugged us.
That what?
Yes. We're not friends or anything, but we respect each other as people. They don't call me nerd.
Smack man, I hate to break it to you, but you are.
No, he's not a right. I'll just kick him out.
What? He's moving again. You can have. He's not a nerd, Devin.
So what if I am a
nerd
or a chili Joe or a faggot or a smack? Whatever the hell that's supposed to mean. So what, Devin? Who cares? I'm not asking you to like me. I'm not asking you to help me. I'm only asking that you respect me.
You have to earn my respect.
No! A kid got killed today for no reason. That's not right. No one should have earned the right to stay alive. If we could all get used to that, we'd be a lot better off. And for your information, my name is Josh.
You go home now. It's over. Come on out.
So hold up. Look, I know they said we leave, but I know we're not finished yet. Before we go, we gotta be.
You know, Jeff thought we were done.
Then forget about him. Before we go, we gotta remember happened. This day, it has to make a difference. And it has to matter.
So what do we do?
We decide we want to be better at this.
How?
By defining what we believe in.
And how do we do that?
Well, hey, we can write down. You know, sweaty ones yet?
Yeah, but somebody rashed the chalk, remember?
Right? Well, here. Let me use these.
Pens.
All right. Let's grab a pen. All
right.
We're going to write the word and leave it on the board.
Liberation. My word. Communication?
Yep.
Pirates. Need to be a lot more accepting sometimes.
But I'll do.
Great. Right.
No, it's not done.
Okay, she's not.
No.
Remember that words do have power. If we have the courage to live by them, without that courage, they're just words. Now we can go.
I know this is gonna sound weird, but this was intense. But cool. Bye, everybody.
Bye, Josh. See you Monday. Thanks.
Can you ride home?
I'm on the west side.
It's okay, I drive over to you where you want to go.
How about you?
I don't know. There's still out there.
Not now. Besides, you can work with us.
That will be all right. Almost ready, Lee.
Yeah, hold on a minute.
You're really into that, aren't you?
Yeah, I used to be. Hey, let's go.
All right. You know what it means?
Just came back to get my cigarettes. So.
You came back. There is nothing more.
It's not that easy.
It's okay. You wrote it. You say it. Say it.
Respect. I don't give respect. At home or school. All the time. Devin, why are you such a bum? Or Devin, why are you such a loser? Or Devin, why are your pants like that? Or Tay, gangster, put your hands on your head so I can risk your ass. Everybody needs respect. I need to do it. Can't people figure that shit out? Oh, a loser enough times. Pretty soon you start believing.
Well, don't. I'm sorry.
Don't wait till I get outside.
Okay. You know, I'm glad you came back. So you would all would talk about it?
First of all, you give me a lot of credit and you have a great show. It's a small house, it's a little tough thing to do. That's great. The question I have is, was there anything in the piece that wasn't said that you would have been said related to the issues that were discussed? I know the broad question, but maybe all of you have something that you wish had been in the piece that not said. It was all said, great.
I'd like to say, I mean, that everybody I've noticed in my age group is really going through the same thing. It's just that their circumstances make what surrounds them different, but they're pretty much feeling the same thing. It's like feeling like, so, you know, torn between what we want, what's expected of us, and what society shows for us, and what our true inside morals are. And it's just, you know, trying not to mold it, that's really hard. It's a struggle like that people a lot of times don't understand. And my dad says, you know, I went through the same thing. But I really believe that just with the times, and I think things are a lot more complex now. You know, it's really hard. And it's hard to put yourself aside and say, you know, well, this person's feeling the same way, so I should do this to them. But get caught up in that, and pretty soon you have a pattern of dogma with each other. And so, like,
that what it is for us. That's such a vibe for us. That's such a cool
story. Actually, do you think the show says that?
Just back not as much as I'd like it to, but in a way it does, because it shows that it doesn't want to be careful. That's what it's really about. It's not about getting out of the screen.
Yeah.
It's about that.
So what specifically, you mentioned this, the conflict between, I can't remember exactly, but what society wants, which I'm feeling inside, more specific, what Jews are more specific to.
Well, like, sex is a mandate, you know, society's like flashing us these images, and, you know, all this, and I'm not a virgin anymore, I wish I'd wait now when I think about it, because those are my morals, but at the same time, society is showing me all this stuff, and it clouded my thinking when I rushed into it. And then all the violence, like he's talking about, you know. It's totally against my morals to sit there and laugh at somebody's getting popped on a stick on the movies, right? Because when I think about it, I say, that's not funny. But you see the movies, and I'll say, like, ah. Like, Pulp Fiction's a perfect example of when the guy's head explodes all over, the guy fully laughing, he's dying, because he's just so... just came out of nowhere, and he's like, you're so shocked, you start laughing. You know? I mean, it totally goes against my life. Caught up in, and it's a struggle when you think about it.
I agree. I do agree with that. It's really difficult because you end up laughing and you can sit there and go, why am I laughing? And you have to question yourself and like ask yourself questions. Or you're really confused and you need to say, why am I laughing? You need to answer that. Otherwise you're just laughing and you don't know why, you just laugh because people are at you. And I think that's important if you question yourself and you question your actions, because you may just do things not that you want to do them. And you don't know why you're doing them. But if you ask yourself why, then you either stop or you continue, but you know why you're doing it. I mean, while I'm doing this play is because I'm getting something out of it. I relate to everything. I love the subjects and the issues that we get out there, and if I wasn't doing it for that, I don't know why I'd be doing it. I'd be doing another play, but it's not. It's something completely different. Something means something a lot to me. It's like these people do.
What aspect means a lot?
The fact that it's real. I mean, not completely real, you know, but it's the closest thing that is out there that's basically what we see. And then it's not adults. That makes a difference.
So how much input do you have in the creative process and playing are you playing yourself? Or do they give you a script?
Well, we helped write. I mean, we didn't help write it, but we entered ideas into their heads and we entered words that would like, I mean, because they couldn't come up with, you know, hoochie. They don't, what, you know, we hear that around us, so it's regular language, you know, for us, but they don't know what that is, so they asked us for words that would make it more realistic, and we gave it to them, and that's what you're hearing.
So did you start with the workshop process, like, they threw you all into a room?
Well, they had a different idea for a show. Like it was gonna be environmentalist, an issue about environmental issues. And we came in and they asked a story about our lives. So they just said, tell us a story. You know, what time in your life when you were really scared? And we all just told them stories about time in life when we were really scared. And they kept asking those questions. And I guess all of our answers like blew their heads off, and they couldn't believe what would scare us. I mean, they thought, a mouse crossing the floor. It was really scary, but it was something completely different than that. I think it blew their heads off, and they decided to write a show about that instead. They're like, we'll save the environmental issues for later.
Can we edit that a little bit? it was close. What happened is that we did, absolutely correct, we had written the whole other script, which we chucked. Lock, stock, and barrel, we chucked the whole thing and started from scratch. Because when most of these guys are here now, I came back for callbacks. The callback, instead of reading from the script, was instead of the question was, instead of things you were afraid of, was we wanted to hear what kids were passionate about. What do you feel strongly about? What makes you burn? What pushes your buttons?
And to describe the experience for us. And so some of the experiences that were written in the show were actually things that happened to somebody up against the wall, gangster. demeanor instead of Filipino. A couple of things that came up were actually told to us. And then, yeah, like they said, Tyre, our scriptwriter, wanted to get current language.
So they didn't know it, but when they were cast, we had no script. We were supposed to start rehearsals the next week, and we brought them back for the first rehearsal, and we said, well, the good news is you're all in the show. The bad news is we don't have a show. But we're working furiously on it. And Ty and Audie and I really panicked, because we thought, we'd spent months working on this other script that dealt with, if you're up on the news, it dealt with the mobile well, Clearview project.
You know.
And it was hot. We were just like, ooh, we can't wait to get this out there, because it was interesting stuff, and it was very potent, but it didn't work. It didn't have the validity and the reality and the importance that this show ended up having for these people. And we said, that's what matters, that's what counts. So how do you win? And off the word we went, creating something that was much more custom fitted.
But I think you asked something else too, Lizzie, about the characters. Another interesting know is that several of them have changed parts into other people's characters, so that even though they learned a character and they were the model for it, some of them are such good actors that they have
become. Devin used to play Nora's part. Actually, Nora used to play Eileen's part. And Maria used to play the part that Eileen is, that Nora.
No.
Nicole, that's it, yeah.
Can't even play Nicole. And, you know, from the director's point of view, Michael, to your question, I think that some of the things that they feel passionately about come through even in how they deliver certain things. These different people will deliver things differently. Tonight, I don't know if you guys heard me laughing, they're always improv.
Yes.
What kind of reaction have you got? I know you've gone to a lot of schools. What level? Junior high, high school? What kind of responses have you got from your peers?
Well, they're, you can't really expect much of a response.
Yeah.
They're
kind
of you can't really expect much of a response from our peers. they kind of just look at it and they don't. I'm sure that they get some of it, you know, they're actually watching it, but they don't let you know that they're watching it.
Do you have a discussion like this after?
Yeah, somebody asked that question.
How
like,
old are you? Let's
were
see
your
how
cigarettes
you go
kidney
crap?
But I want to also put an addendum to that, because in some of the places that we went to Santa Maria, a school in Santa Maria where this incident, a similar incident to this actually happened. We heard and we were warned that it was really tough there. And it was. It's a tough-edged, hard-edged kind of school. And I was amazed that, surprisingly, they were a receptive audience. I will tell you that they cheered a lot during fight scene. But I think that they got it. Their opening school, we didn't do too many high school. I want to also tell you that. But our experience was, and even Devin and some people told us, high school, they don't want to know about it.
So what level did
you
junior high?
And in some junior highs, they were stoic. They didn't show anything. Other junior highs, they were just all over the place, enjoying it.
And responses, a lot of times, the most potent responses we got were on two different levels. One was when the assembly was over and the group started to leave, people would one by one come up and say, but they didn't want to say that in front of their peers, because it's not cool to strip the peers.
And a principal came over and told us that he had a student exactly.
We also got letters from people
letters.
Afterwards, and there was a group that came the last time they were at Center Stage, a group of McCoober came at McCoober Middle School, and they were so impressed with the show, and they were like the troubled kids that were brought in here. They were so impressed, they petitioned the principal to bring the school to McCoober, and we're going there tomorrow.
You will bring the show.
The principal didn't want it. She said, no, we don't want the show. But the kids went
that's
to her with these petitions and said, we want the show.
The letters have been really striking. I mean, it's really sweet to see some of the kids saying, I like that you're doing characters just like me. You can read it.
Yeah. If they're not floating in my brain.
Yeah.
Are they?
and they schedule it in. So.
Yeah. Do you have any ideas why the high school is coming to spot and the junior high school is here?
Well, and Mike, because I go to high school, I went to high school right now, because I took it to, like, understand. But I think basically in high school, even though you're confused, you basically are set what you're going to do and the kind of person you're going to be. And that's how the cliques get started, basically. And you're not going to listen to somebody else tell you, you can't do that. And you're like, what the hell are you talking about? Just get out of my face. Because I know somebody tried to change me in high school. They're like, stop. Don't, you know. I think junior high school kids, they'll put on that face like, well, we don't care. But I think you can reach them more. Like, they won't show it, but you will. Whereas high school, they won't show it because they don't.
Mm. That was my question. I like, you know, whoever wants to respond, but you put up words up there like compassion, acceptance, and things like that, and I'm very interested in that. What do you think, when do you think kids are receptive to hearing about those principles in life? And when do you think they can start learning about that in an education type of way? What age is that ideal?
Start in sixth grade.
Yeah.
Because, like, kids in seventh grade at my school, even, like, the so-called softest people, they won't really, like, get the whole picture. They'll just get little teeny snatches of it. And, like, the elementary school people, they're, like, soaking it. They're, like, whoa, cool. I want some more.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, because it was different when we had, like, D.A.R.E. come to our school in elementary. We loved our Officer Hunter. We didn't think he was stupid. I can imagine it out. Wow. I mean, if a policeman came to our school, we'd be like, ah, oh, get away, pig, you know, whatever. We'd hate him. We wouldn't like it all. What?
What age was that when
No, I'm just saying in junior high, like seventh, eighth, ninth grade. He wouldn't like it. It'd just be annoying. But in elementary, it was like, ah,
but yeah. Do you think kids, like in sixth grade, can get those principles, like acceptance?
I mean, they probably wouldn't go, you know, walk around going, I accept you, you know, I have compassion towards you, but they have a better chance there than in, you know, junior high and high school.
I think that even at a younger age, there's going to be some people who think that they don't need it, but I know that even in high school and junior high, everybody right now, I know my generation, there's so many people who are feeling completely lost, but society tells them, like Devin said, society tells them, their peers tell them, but it's just not right to feel that way. And acceptance is, I mean, it should be a major issue, but people don't even try at this point.
Yeah.
Because everyone's got their pain, and people get so self-absorbed in their own pain that they can't see anybody else's.
Yeah.
And just,
so it's really prevalent, and
it's
a lot of
pain. There's so much pain in high school, and I can't even express how much help people need. But no matter what we do, I think that people, they're just not gonna want it, they want it, but they can't express it. And even when they get it, like some of these kids in junior high, I know that all of them got it, because all of them feel this pain. We all do, but they can't express it.
I think the ideal age to do it was, you know, when they're babies, understand, but that's where it starts, man. You have such this innocent, untainted little human being, and if you put that in there, you don't grow up to be a wonderful person. I know for me, you know, I got jacked up really. I don't know who else got jacked up. That affected the way I am now, you know. I mean, I'm still okay. No, but, yeah, I think babies are ideal. Maybe. That's why I love babies. They're so innocent. Can't hate them, it's just a fresh thing.
Seventh and eighth grade, I went to a Catholic school the last 2 years, and they need it just as bad as public schools do. And I think that even though they're in junior high, they still get the message, and a lot of ninth graders I know, like she's saying, they could do what they should. I think, personally, ninth graders are tempted.
But they don't want to accept anyone else trying to help them with their problems.
But some of them do. And they won't admit it, like, out loud in front of everybody, but they do.
It's not a cool thing to want.
You know, like Devin said, I don't think
I think your original question is, like, when's the ideal time to start learning about these ideas? You can't start these ideas too early, you know? I mean, why start when you're in sixth grade, you know? I mean, maybe this play is a good age for, like, sixth and up, but, you know, you gotta start early, you know? There's no time that's too soon to start telling, you know, people, you know, it's okay if someone's different, you know? You don't all have to be this little perfect mold of, you know, it's, you can't start too early.
Yeah.
But in a lot of ways, you can't start too late either. I mean, there's always the need. It's so, it's there. It's very real.
Even in fifth grade, I could have used this play.
So, one thing I was noticed, especially with the father, you know, I think about watching some music, like I went to do stuff about Kurt Cobain and things like that. To me, it's really depressed. I mean, it's really, it's heavy. The vibe is very heavy. People look heavy. I mean, it's sad. And this is. Kids are not like, don't seem like people that are really, really terribly affected as kids. But you're saying in the plastic the right way. But that's the vibe.
There's a lot of hurt.
What?
There's a lot of hurt.
Yeah.
Just going around.
It's just a whole bunch of pent up aggression that they've been keeping inside themselves for too long. They don't know how to express it and like let it out. They don't know who to let it out to.
I'm teaching in an elementary school to kind of go along with what you're saying, and I notice I teach storytelling and theater, and at second grade already when they have a chance to do any kind of improv they want, I would say 98%, especially the boys, even though the kids, do an angry improv first. And there was a situation where in the class was in third grade, they were already making racist remarks to each other, and then there was a discussion.
So my feedback is that this is one point of view is that there's a lot of pain there, but if I reflect back when I was your age, which was like mainly in the 50s and the 60s, it's like we lived in a time where all these things, the violence or the racism and all that stuff, it was just like a way of life. There was no sensitivity about it. So the reason, the good news, the way I see it, is that you have, for one reason or another, your generation is coming in with a lot of sensitivity towards things that really do need to be changed. So it's kind of like the other side of it. We had the same thing, a lot of the same thing. We just that's the way it is. We just laugh and have a good time.
I think it's just a lot of us can't laugh and have a good time about it. A lot of us, the anger comes out because there's so much pain. And everybody's fighting. And we're trying to stop the fighting. The more pain there is, the more anger there is. And if we could just laugh about it and have a good time about it, that would be great. But for some reason, I mean,
sensitivity is one of the reasons.
Well, you could like walk by somebody in the hallway and go, hi, and they'll like think you're offensive. Like one kid actually got shot from giving another kid fun. And so.
Or they put you down for saying hello. I think that a lot of people are sensitive about it, but you can't admit it. That they admit it, they're lame, they're weird.
But you should be, I mean, it's hard to do, I mean, it's hard to say and actually do, but you should be sure enough of yourself, if they don't say hi back, to just say basically screw you, you know? I don't need your nasty looks. It's not that you have to do it back, but just say to yourself, okay, well, I offered my hand. I didn't accept.
My generation is so screwed up because we're procrastinators who are too hard on ourselves. I mean, we've got like the world on our shoulders. We've inherited all this shit, right?
Yeah.
And then we sit on our asses and play Nintendo and say, what am I gonna do? And then we say, you're a sucker, man. You're not doing anything about it. And those two emotions, they drive you crazy. I mean, and when you're sitting here like doing nothing and then getting pissed at yourself for doing nothing. And then you get pissed off at yourself, and it's just a circle.
And Devin said before that there's complexity, I think, in my view, with what we're talking about. There's just more things and sensitivity.
I don't feel like I'm alone with this, but this is not a high school condition. I mean, this is an adult condition. And, I mean,